Hi everyone. I just want to update you how well the Chinese is doing at the school at the moment. From early learning center, they know how to say a full sentence. All the kids in primary and secondary, they come to us saying that they love Chinese. They want to learn Chinese every day now.
I'm passionate about Chinese because Chinese is a language that I feel like has almost been forgotten. And Chinese is really so important and increasingly important to our future. If we see that, you know, Chinese is the second most spoken language in Australia. Australia reliant on trade with China, our economy. Employers, when they're looking for employees, they're now looking at, can you speak a second language? And this is really, really important. And I'm so passionate about helping the students to realise the importance of Chinese and how Chinese will play a part of their future. But you don't necessarily need to want to live in China, study in China, go to university in China, for Chinese to be really important to you. The AFL and the Rugby League are now really interested in breaking into the Chinese market and seeing players that are Asia capable.
你叫什么名字?
我叫Brenna.
我叫Emily.
你叫什么名字?
我叫Ryan.
I think as for me, the reason I'm passionate about the Chinese is because of the kids' passion about Chinese. And the way they run to me, they hug me, they're saying about, you know, when is Chinese lesson? You know, and that really just keep me going and knowing that, you know, the kids' potential to learn Chinese is there.
你叫Emily, 你几岁了?
Do you think they are same or they're different?
她是她的爸爸。
How Chinese has been taught in the past in schools hasn't been very effective, but we've decided to replace it with what's called HSK, the Hanyu Shui Ping Kao Shi, which is a standardised Chinese language exam. Now this exam is taken by government officials in China, it's taken by professionals, university students, it's even being taken by our federal parliament member. He's looking to sit HSK as well. But HSK is not just about doing an exam and being able to say that you've passed that level, but it's also going to help the students because they're receiving QCE credits. So whereas Chinese in the past, students haven't been able to reach the level required to get QCE credits, with HSK now they can. So each HSK test that they sit, they'll get the equivalent of about 1 to 2 QCE credits depending on the level, which means it's helping them towards graduating as well.
So that's our Chinese program. You've seen the bits and pieces, you've seen the little kids talking, you've seen the big kids, you've seen some of the tutors that we've got in action. There have been 67 national reports into language education in Australia, and the one consistent finding is that we're going backwards. We're determined not to wait for the 68th report. We're a school that's trying to have a focus on getting students ready for a globalised future in the workforce. We're trying to be the place that that gets kids ready for the Asian future. To do that, we have to somehow come to terms with Chinese and how we can train kids in Chinese to be the kind of people that industry is looking for. So we've found that we've just got to reinvent it. We're having a go at it. We've got some wins. We've got some failures. We're struggling hard, but we think we're on a good track. We hope you've enjoyed this little brief where you've been able to have a chance to see what we're having a go with in Chinese. We'll get better and we'll get stronger, but we've got a foothold and we think we're onto something good. We're glad your kids are growing in Chinese. This is just another way that we're trying to help them to flourish.